So welcome to this video on solving linear systems using the QR decomposition. We've already seen in a previous video that the standard way to solve general linear systems is to use LU factorization. We've also seen that if you have a special matrix, you can do something like Cholesky decomposition, but that only holds for symmetric positive definite matrices. Now, in this video, I would like to use the QR decomposition. So we have already seen that you have the Schur format for a matrix. You can write any matrix A as Q times R, Q being orthogonal, R upper triangular. And this you can also use to solve linear systems. Now, this is not a standard way. You won't do this in general, but it has some benefits. I will point those out. And also, it will become clear when we look at systems where you have more equations than unknowns over determined linear systems, least squares problems, that you can still use this method. So that's why I already presented at this stage. So let's look at a little outline of the presentation. So let me go to the slides here. So I will talk a little bit, if you have the QR decomposition, how can you use it to solve linear systems? And then I will say a little bit on how you can actually compute a QR decomposition. So you can use the Gram-Schmidt procedure, but for numerics, that is not the best way to do it. So I will present two different ways, Hausdorff transformations and Givens rotations. Those will be the topics of other videos, but I will just name them here. So let's see. We have seen that you can compute the QR decomposition for any matrix, at least in theory. How to do it numerically, we will see. So Q is orthogonal, which means that Q transpose is its inverse. As you may recall, for instance, rotations are these, then Q rotates a vector over a certain angle alpha. Q transpose or Q inverse rotates back. They preserve length. And this R matrix here is upper triangular. Now, how can you use that? So first, we compute the QR decomposition in some way. Next, we have a linear system, AX equals B, and we would like to find the solution X. So what I do, I plug in the QR decomposition, and then we have QRX equals B. And then we know that Q transpose is Q inverse, so I can multiply from the left with Q transpose and this Q are the identity together, so they disappear, and we have the new linear system Rx equals Q transpose B, and R is an upper triangular matrix, so we can quickly solve this, and that is the last step using backward substitution. So that is how you can employ, how you can use a QR decomposition to solve a linear system. So how does this compare? Why would you do this rather than LU decomposition? Well, it does not require pivoting, so that can be an advantage. If you don't want to do any pivoting, you don't want to think about that, you can use this. As I said, it also works for overdetermined systems. For least squares problems, you will have more equations than unknowns, which means that you cannot solve all of them, and you have to do some approximation, and you can use this here. And you should know that it requires more operation. So in terms of how much computations it takes, how much time it takes, it's slower than LU decomposition. Now, how do you find a QR decomposition? In a previous video where we discussed QR decomposition, I presented the Gram-Schmidt method. But if you do that numerically, then due to the round of errors, the columns of your Q matrix will not be orthogonal. So Q is an orthogonal matrix, which means that the columns of Q, so if I split it, if I write Q in terms of its columns, Q1, Q2, up to Qn, say, then we know that if you compute the dot product of Qi with Qj, you find delta ij, Kronecker delta. So if I equals j, you find 1, which means that all the columns have length 1. If they are different, I unequal j, you have 0, which means that they are orthogonal, they're perpendicular. Now, if you do it numerically using Gram-Schmidt, they probably won't be. So A sound way to do that numerically is using Hausholder transformations, and that will be the topic of a new video. Another way is to use Givens rotations, which will also be in a future video. Then, if you look in MATLAB, you can use the QR command, so you can call that like this. So you ask for two matrices, Q and R and QRA, and your matrix does not need to be squared, can be of course, but it will produce an upper triangular and a unitary or orthogonal, if it's real, matrix Q. So a rather short video this time. Let's see what have we seen. If you have the QR decomposition of a matrix, you can use it to solve it. The standard way is LU factorization, and we have seen a couple of reasons why you would want, why you might want to use QR decomposition rather than LU. And we have sketched some methods to compute the QR decomposition, but we will see more details in future videos. So thanks for watching. If you have any questions or comments, let me know. And this concludes it for this video. Bye.